Hello guys, have you ever wondered what is the difference between the two JZ GE con rods and the two JZ GTE connected rods? Okay, in this video, you guys are going to find out. And welcome to 2JZ Tuesday. My name is Michael Chung, and I'm going to show you guys what are the differences between these two. Coming up! I got two of them now, so you can see that this one, the thick version one, this one is the GTE version, okay? And then this one is a thin one, this one is like a 4AG, but both of them are for 2JZ, this one is for the 2JZ GE, VVTi, especially VVTi. And this one is the 2JZ GTE and 2JZ non-VVTi. But somehow I was able to open up from 2JZ GE VVTi. I managed to find this one. So maybe the previous owner has already swapped in. So it depends on your luck. But mostly 2JZ GTE has thicker con rods. Okay, so I'm going to share with you guys what are the things that you should notice when you are getting your con rods fitting in into your engine. Okay, so for this one, the 2JZ GE one, this one is very, very thin. So this one is like a 4AG connecting rods. So better don't use it for high horsepower applications, all right? But on the other hand, this one, the 2JZ GTE con rods, you can use up to 600 horsepower. But also it depends on your oil starvation and the bearing got any issues or not. Okay, so all this, it depends on your condition of your engine. Okay, so I'm going to share with you guys the similarities. Okay, the piston pins are the same, the length are the same, the diameter, because both of them are using the same crankshaft, are the same, the bearings position all are the same. However, if you guys have tried before, you guys will know that the weakness of this con rod is actually the bolts. Okay, if you can try to change into ARP bolts, that will be the best, alright? And then mostly when we do engine build up, we need to change the con rod bearings into new ones, okay? Don't save money for it, okay? Even though you can see that it is like still sparkly new, but try to change new ones, alright? Okay, so I'm going to show you guys some of the clearances that I got from Toyota, okay? Some of them may be useful and some of them may not be useful. This one is up to you. But when you receive your 2JZ con rods, it is best for you to check the truss, okay, the oil clearances, everything you check before you install. Okay, after you install the piston pin, the piston, you try to wriggle it and see whether it is too much of a free play. Then you immediately go and check the truss clearances, all right? And then over here, this one is to check your crank pin diameter, crank pin oil clearances. Okay, so when you install the piston inside the engine, and then when you try to install the crank pin into the crankshaft, okay, you try to use either the plastic gauge or the dial bore gauge to measure what is the oil clearance. Okay, not too tight, but not too loose. Okay. So I'm going to show you guys the diameters down below. So I hope you guys learned something from this video. Hope you guys can understand more about these con rods. And don't forget to subscribe if you guys find these videos are informative, and share with your friends. And hopefully we guys can learn more in engine building too, right? Comment below if you guys got any questions, and I try to answer you guys as much as I can. And see you.